Welcome dear aspirants, this video is to explain to you about angel tax. You might have heard of angel tax from the recent budget, interim budget presented by the NDA government and the related issues associated with angel tax. So to analyze that issues closely, you have to know, have to have an understanding about what angel tax per se is. Angel tax is an income tax collected from companies which are not listed. That means which are not listed in the stock exchange. That means if a company which is not listed in a stock exchange is collecting money, raising money, investment through shares, selling of shares, and if the government comes to know that the share value which they have received is more than the fair value, fair market price of their share or expected from their share based on their net asset value calculation by the state, in that context, they are supposed to consider this as an income which is raised from investors, and this money shall be taxed. Sometimes it may take away 30% of the total investment from which they receive in the form of angel investment, and that is the issue of startups, because startups are fundamentally working based on the money which they are receiving as angel investment, because they can't directly go to the share market and receive investment from there. So what they are expected to do is to receive angel investment, to find an angel investor and receive it. But here the problem is, if the investor is speculative and if he is considering the prospectus other than considering what is the assets and liabilities of the company from the balance sheet, other than using that kind of a method, if he is analyzing it in different methods and investing more money, that shall not be considered or treated as an investment. Rather, it shall be considered from the company's end as an additional income which is liable for taxation. For a country like India, which is considered to be home of the second largest number of companies which are belonging to the startup category, this was entirely affecting the ecosystem of startups in India. So this was a problem, and this has been so. And here the problem was the cap was so less that up to 10 crore angel tax was applicable, and there was an outcry from the part of the startup investors in India, stakeholders in India, to reconsider this. And angel tax was introduced in India in 2012 by the UPA government. Pranab Mukherjee as the finance minister, he introduced this. And the very purpose of introduction of angel tax was the angel investment route was used for money laundering in India by forming shell companies and giving values which is far more than their fair market price, and they were trying to launder their money which was placed elsewhere. They were using it for round tripping of their money to Indian economy. So to prevent this, we have introduced angel tax. But now, to protect the interest of the investors as well as the startups, we are now going for certain rearrangements regarding angel tax. We have not rejected the proposal to introduce angel tax. Rather, we have kept the cap as 25 crore, a blanketed exemption on receiving three declarations, which is self-attested declaration from the companies. All companies which is having collected an investment of 25 crore shall be now exempted from angel tax. This is a welcome move, and there is positive vibes from the angel investors as well as from the startup ecosystem. There is positive response to this, because this is going to make India a better investment destination for angel investors. So this is the thing which has brought this thing into news now. So here you have to know about what is angel investment, and you have to know what is angel tax, and what was the actual purpose behind introduction of angel tax, and last thing, what is the recent changes which happened in angel tax and how it was prohibiting the growth of startup environment in India, and all these things are included in this video. Now go through this video and analyze all these facts, and you can go through the newspaper for more information. Thank you.